Developments tonight in an attack that targets the U.S. Coast Guard. A suspect crashes into their building, assaults officers, and claims to have a bomb. 7 Action News reporter Simon Chaiquette is downtown outside the FBI Detroit field office with more.
As a former FBI spokesman here at the Detroit field office, I can tell you this investigation is far from over, and it's one that initially resembled an act of domestic terrorism.
A terrifying scene involving the driver of this pickup truck, a 34-year-old man crashing into a U.S. Coast Guard station early this morning. The incident following a telephone bomb threat, all of it happening in the popular resort town of Grand Haven.
In Grand Rapids, near where this incident happened, there is a very large resident agency with probably 20-plus agents that work in there.
Former FBI Special Agent in Charge Dan Roberts reacting to the scary scene from earlier today. Sources say the unidentified suspect also assaulted Coast Guard personnel before he was arrested. The FBI, with offices in nearby Grand Rapids, springing into action today, chasing down leads to determine a motive.
You don't know at this point. It could be anything, as you say, from being a mentally ill individual to somebody that has an axe to grind with the Coast Guard, perhaps even a disgruntled employee.
No explosives were discovered inside the Dodge Ram pickup despite threats from the driver. On Twitter, the U.S. Coast Guard updating citizens throughout the day. We do know the suspect's home on the west side of the state caught fire earlier in the morning, but few details are available. While it was first treated as an act of domestic terrorism, the FBI has since stated there is no known link to terrorism at this time.
And even though they may have come out with a statement saying that, you know, we're confident or we don't believe that this is linked to any terrorist organizations, they're still doing deep dives into that individual's cell phone records, probably his computer records, email accounts, and things like that.
Tonight, the FBI is still working to determine a motive. Meantime, that suspect remains locked up. From downtown Detroit, Simon Chaiquette, 7 Action News.